and House Speaker Tim Jones, who was there as well. Buddy, how you doing?
Hey, good morning. You did a fine job last night, my friend, keeping all of us in line.
Hey,
moving it along.
You know what was great about it, though? As typical as with your approach and everything, it's just straightforward. It's right to the point. It's courageous. It was just great stuff. You had a great presentation last night and actually just recommitted yourself and all of us to making sure we were going to defend ourselves at all counts from what Obamacare eventually is going to do.
Well, absolutely, Jamie. And, you know, I had a few takeaways last night that confirm my convictions about what we've been doing here in Missouri. And number one, you know, I took away that people are frightened, confused, and do not want Obamacare. You know, we had, as you mentioned, this was an open invitation to the entire St. Louis region. It was not catered to any particular audience. And you had a diverse group that showed up last night, all age groups, all colors, all creeds. Nearly 500 people inside, a couple hundred had to be turned away. Huge success. And so I took that away from people. And the other thing I took away, Jamie, although we had all kinds of age groups there, the people that I heard from the most last night were on the bookends of life. It was the young people who do not want this thing. They don't want to pay for it. They don't want to be forced to buy something that they can't afford. And the older folks who are very worried about what's going to happen to their health care options and choices as they're at the stage of life where they need the best health care, the most affordable health care, the most. And Obamacare, Jamie, as Vince Blair and Dr. Tobler pointed out, is not going to deliver that. It's going to be expensive. It's going to be unaffordable. And the government is now going to tell you what you can receive.
Yeah. And you know what's interesting is that people are so confused. And just as a side comment I made last night, I wondered whether that was really the point of all this, that the idea that Nancy Pelosi brought up, which is they'll read the bill after it's passed, because they really didn't care what was in it. And they don't care that a lot of us are out there, you know, scrambling and trying to tread water here, trying to deal with it. I'm talking about individuals and small businesses.
Absolutely. And Jamie, we have never, ever, ever seen this before in our entire nation's history. And we can say this about so many aspects of Obamacare, but the preeminent one is, when have we ever instituted a new government handout or entitlement or program or whatever you want to call this, where 3.5 years post-hence, it hasn't been implemented, it's having a tough time being implemented, very few people, even the experts, understand it, and most people, nearly 60% of the nation, doesn't want it. I think that is remarkable, and if the Democrats aren't careful, they're going to have another tidal wave smash into them in the 2014 elections, because no Democrat I know, Jamie, is running on Obamacare in Missouri next year and in most of the rest of the country. And I talk to a lot of people from coast to coast.
Yeah, Tim, they won't even call it Obamacare. And I point out last night, it's like James Monroe saying, please don't call this the Monroe Doctrine. You know, honestly, it's the same damn thing, because these guys, all the media, by the way, the media didn't show up last night, save for Joe Manish with the Beacon. And I didn't see her story yet. But
it was a decent story, Jamie. I read it this morning. And thank goodness for objective, honest reporters, old school reporters like Joe Manish, who are still out there.
Yeah. I mean, and this is, it's an online publication, but you know what? This is a place, this attracted 600 people. This was a huge event. And I realize that body found in the alley in North St. Louis is the lead story for you folks. But the reality is this thing was important because it showed that people are concerned about their futures. These are real life concerns.
Jamie, the takeaway and the biggest thing that hit home with me, the thing that just really caused the place to come to a hush, was when that one nice lady stood up and said, because of my beliefs and because of what I want to do in my life, I don't want this thing. I don't want government in my health care.
Yeah. I mean, and she was shaking.
She was. She was because she doesn't know what's going to happen in a
yeah.
few weeks, in a few months. And she wants no part of it.
Well, we appreciate the fact that you gave us that night last night, Tim, being there, and really loved your presentation. But again, appreciate your support, and thanks for a great job. Job well done. At Speaker Tim Jones is where you can follow Tim Jones on Twitter. And, buddy, we appreciate you as always.
Jimmy, thank you. We can do some really smart health care reforms in this state and across the country that will lower cost and improve access. Obamacare is not the answer. Republicans do have some answers, and we're going to be working on that next session.
All right, brother. Hey, thank you very much. It's Tim Jones, Speaker of the House.